Hi, gang. This is magnetic viewing film. It allows you to see where magnetic fields are, provided they're strong enough. I'll show you how it works, along with some neat demonstrations. How does it work? Let's look at one of the ends of this magnet, a north or south pole, it doesn't matter which. Notice that we see the magnetic field as darker and brighter areas. Over the magnet's face, it's darker, but its edges are brighter. If we were looking at the magnetic viewing film under high magnification, we'd see that it's coated with many tiny, transparent microcapsules. Each capsule is filled with oil and a tiny flake of nickel. The nickel flake is thin in these directions and flat in these directions. In a magnetic field, the nickel flakes line up with their flat faces parallel with the magnetic field lines, like this, just like iron filings would. But notice here that the flat side of this nickel flake is facing you, and the light. The nickel flake is also shiny, so the flat side reflects light, and we see that as a bright spot on the viewer. Now look at the dark area over here. Again, the flakes line up parallel with the magnetic field, but that means the reflective flat sides are no longer facing the light. Instead, the thin edges are. And now we see a dark spot on the viewer. So the magnetic field lines are perpendicular to the viewing film where the film is darker, and they're parallel where the film is bright. You can do a lot of neat things with magnetic viewing film. Here's an old camera. Moving the film over it, we see a magnetic field here. The camera's speaker is in there. Most types of speakers contain magnets. Here's a magnet from an old hard disk drive. Notice that the face of the magnet has both a north and a south pole. And notice that we can't tell which is which. The magnetic viewing film doesn't help us with that. You've probably seen the demonstration where you drop a magnet down a metal tube and the magnet falls slowly. If we put the magnetic viewing film over the tube, we can see where the induced magnetic field is, and therefore where the magnet is. Notice the bright line that seems to be in the middle. Here's a stack of neodymium magnets on its own. Notice that from their side, there's the bright line across the middle of the stack. In fact, you can follow that brightness from one face all along to the other face. Remember, the brightness is where the film is most parallel to the magnetic field, so we're following it around the magnet. And here's how I erase it between tests, by waving this big stack of ceramic magnets near it. Here's a nail that I wrapped some wire around to make an electromagnet. As I turn up the power supply, the electromagnetic field becomes strong enough to affect the magnetic viewer. And here's a larger electromagnet that I made. And again, we can see the field at the end. But also we can see that line on the side where the film is most parallel to the electromagnetic field. And you can also have fun with different configurations of magnets. From boring old rectangular, to things more sinister looking. Well, thanks for watching. I was inspired to make this video from watching this cool magnetic propulsion video by Ben from his Applied Science channel. At one point, he makes use of some magnetic viewing film. Click here to watch it, or on the link in this video's description. And see my YouTube channel, rimstar.org, for more interesting videos like this. That includes one about magnetic fields and demonstrations with iron filings, another explaining how radiation works, using an americium pellet from a smoke detector as an example, and one on whether it's the volts or the amps that kills you. And don't forget to subscribe if you like these videos, or give a thumbs up, share with your social media, or leave a question or comment below. See you in a bit.